Hi everyone, so this video is a painting for the YouTube Artists Collective. This is my second time participating, and this time the theme was Grimm's Fairy Tales, and a lot of us were really excited about this theme. We were really happy that this was the one that was decided on, and as always, the original painting will be sold on my shop, so there'll be a link in the description. So if you don't know what the YouTube Artists Collective is, we're a group of YouTube artists. We get together every few months and make a piece of art based off of one theme, so we all kind of branch off of the same theme. And the theme is chosen by you, and it's voted on in the Facebook group, so the link to the Facebook group will also be in the description, and all the other members I will link in the description. And we actually have a few guest artists this time as well, so they will also be in the description. Please make sure you check out everyone else's videos. We are also doing a calendar that kind of like compiles a bunch of the artworks that a few of us have done. Not everyone, but a lot of us are participating in the calendar, me included, and it's going to be on sale today, November 3rd to December 15th, so if you want a 2018 YouTube Artist Collective calendar, make sure you grab one while you can, because they're not going to be available forever. That will also be linked in the description, so there's a lot of stuff in the description. So the theme was Grimm's Fairy Tales, and what I chose to do, the story that I chose, I just kind of looked through a bunch of them, and I chose one that I've never really heard of before. It's called The Seven Ravens, and I'll give you a little summary of the story. So basically, there's like a father and a mother, and they have seven sons, but they really want a girl. So they have a baby girl, but she's really weak, so the sons go off to get water to baptize her because she might die, and the parents want her to be baptized before she dies. And then they're taking too long to get the water because they like drop the bucket in the well or something. So the father turns them into ravens. There's seven of them, and they all fly away. And when the little girl grows up, she actually ends up living, and she grows up nice and healthy and strong. She finds out that her brothers were turned into ravens, and she thinks that it's her fault. So she goes to find them, eventually reunites with them, and they get turned back into humans. That's kind of the story. I just really like the whole idea of this story because the girl never has really met her brothers before. Like, when she was a baby, of course she met them, but does she really remember them? But she still is willing to go out into the world and find her brothers and save them all by herself. And I think this would make a really interesting Disney movie, like if they animated this one and made it into a story and kind of like fleshed out all the details. I think this could be really, really interesting. So I just really like the idea of the story, and also it includes birds, ravens, which are my favorite animal. Not ravens, but birds in general are my favorite animal. And I was looking up some reference photos of ravens so I could kind of draw them a bit accurately, and I realized just how big they are compared to people. I don't know if I made them big enough. They're huge. Ravens are so big, and I thought crows were big, but they're way bigger than crows, and I guess I just never really realized how big they are before, and it was kind of cool to find that out. So I kind of had to change the composition a little bit because of they were a lot bigger than I expected them to be. And this painting was so much fun. I love watercolor. It's my favorite medium. I love to use it. At the beginning, it was kind of getting away from me. It was getting really messy, and it wasn't really looking the way I wanted it to, but I think I pulled it together in the end, and I just really like the style of it. I like that I kept it simple because I tend to overwork things a lot, especially watercolor, because I feel like I have to draw things a certain way and I have to add a certain level of detail, and I kind of accidentally limit myself to how much I can style like background elements. There was a few moments where I was gonna go into a certain area of the painting and add a whole bunch of detail, but I had to stop myself because I just took a step back and looked at it and thought, this doesn't need more detail. This is good the way it is. And I do think it could use a little bit more lighter values, but I think it's okay. It's just very mid-tone heavy, I think. But I like the colors that I use. I wanted it to be very, very fall-like, very in season, because who doesn't love fall? And I guess some people might not like fall because it brings winter, maybe they don't like winter. I really like the transition periods between winter and summer. I just think that's when the nicest weather is. I tried to get some different angles for this video. I wanted to also show you some like slower footage because I think watercolor is so fun to watch when it's at normal speed, because it's just relaxing just to see the water getting painted in slowly and seeing the brush, like the way the bristles move. I just think that's really relaxing and fun to watch. So I wanted to edit it that way so you could see kind of my process and how I make the marks on the paper. I kind of did my normal process where I start off by just going in with a whole bunch of loose watery colors and then refining it with further layers. And then at the end, I went in with my favorite brush pen to kind of go around everything and define everything, and I think that always pulls it together really, really nicely. I like to leave the outlines until the end because I just find I don't know, I just find it always looks better that way, and my line work looks more spontaneous and not as stiff if I am outlining after I color. And as always, everything I used will be linked in the description, so all my materials, if you want to know anything that I use. If you are confused about something, you can leave a comment, but make sure you check the description to see all my materials, because that's where I always put my materials. And I'm using the Winsor & Newton Cotman watercolors just to clear that up, because I got a lot of questions about what watercolors I use. I've been wanting to kind of upgrade my watercolors for a while because they're just not very pigmented. I just have a hard time getting certain colors onto the paper. And I actually have one better quality one. It's the red. It's like the artist grade professional quality one. They're really, really old. I think they were my dad's or something, but I use them now. And the red one is amazing. I love it so much. It's my favorite color to use because it's just so easy to get the color off of it. And the other ones are just not nearly as pigmented. So I might start slowly investing and upgrading my watercolor, but I don't really know yet. And I know that the ravens don't look black. I didn't want to make them black. I wanted to bring a level of coolness to all the warm colors. I wanted to kind of, so that's why I made the trees more purpley, because that's more, that's like a cool red, sort of. The birds are blue and red, so I kind of made them warm and cool. They don't look black, but I think it's okay because I wanted them to look this way. I wanted the ravens to look like this. They might not necessarily look like ravens, but I tried to kind of give them the same feature. They have like really long beaks that kind of round at the end. So I tried to do that. And using this brush pen is just so much fun. I love it so much. It's my favorite thing. It's just, it's been lasting me so long. And I thought that I broke the tip of it. I thought that I ruined it, but it's actually has been holding up really, really nicely for a long time. So I'm really happy about that. Also at the beginning, I don't know if you noticed, but as I was sketching it, I suddenly came in with like a printed off version of the sketch. That's because I took it into my computer digitally and I made a digital sketch of it and then printed it off. I love to do this because it allows you to like make a composition really, really quickly, because digital art is easy for that. You can move stuff around, play with colors. So I always do that part digitally, but I didn't leave that in the video because it would have been too long and I wanted to focus on the watercolor part of it, which is my main concern. The Grimm's fairy tales are basically stories, so I like to do stuff in the storybook style. It's one of my favorite things. It just comes really naturally to me, so I enjoyed this so much. And if you want the original, if you want to buy the actual painting, the link to my shop is in the description. But if you want prints or anything else like that, basically anything you can get off of Redbubble, it'll be linked in the description as well. So like prints, shirts, stickers, stuff like that, phone cases, pillows, anything like that, also in the description. And make sure you check out all the other artists. I'm so excited to see what everyone does for this theme. It's just such a like inspiring theme. You can choose whatever story you want to make a drawing of, and there's so many to choose from, so I'm really excited to see what everyone else does. So go check out everyone else. If you want the original, make sure you check it out, and also check out the calendar. There's a lot of things in the description that you can check out. So I really hope you enjoyed this. I definitely enjoyed making this painting. I'm happy with the way it turned out. I really like what I did. Of course, there's always things I wish I could change, but I think it's okay. It turned out the way I envisioned it to turn out, so that is good. So I really hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in my next video.